So this book is called The Globetrotter Diaries, and it's a book of 40 short stories all about some great adventure travel and luxury travel that I've had in my life. So you sort of go around the world in the experience, but woven into the stories a lot of tips and tactics and things of getting you out of jams, or you know, some great travel tips that you might use when you're traveling around the world. Well, I'll give you one. You know, remember when the volcano hit in Europe, the Iceland volcano, and the ash went over all of Europe, and I was sort of stranded in London, not a bad place to be stranded, but trying to figure out how to get to Italy, which is where I was going. And one great little tip, you know, it was pandemonium at all the train stations, and I was going to miss a train that was going to get me over to France and then down into Italy. And what I did is walk to the very front of the line, and whoever was standing in the front of the line, I said, if you buy my ticket, I will pay for your ticket. And you know, how can you refuse that? So, you know, I was the 50 people in line, I was able to jumpstart it and get a ticket and buy the other person's ticket. So just a little tip in terms of dealing with lines and crowds. Another great example is, you know, I once was flying from New York to Los Angeles, and after I got out of the airport, I realized I left my iPad on the plane. So I thought, you know, well, I might as well kiss that goodbye. But I decided to work it backwards, and I went to the baggage counter and told them my story, and they gave me a reverse pass to get through security so that I could get back to the plane, even though I didn't have a boarding pass. So you can get back into a terminal or back to a plane if you don't have a boarding pass for an actual flight, if you explain your situation, and the TSA will help you do that. So a couple of, you know, great little tips. I'm always working the flight system. You know, the thing about the trick is to do it far in advance. And you know, people think that they can call up 3 weeks in advance and get an upgrade or get a flight, and that's hard to do. So you got to do it far in advance. I say do it a lot on if you're an American, do it a lot on American holidays. So travel on American holidays, because there are a lot of people who aren't necessarily traveling globally, especially. And I'm a big user of partner airlines. So when I go to South America, the first airline I call is LAN Chile. And generally I can get, it's a great airline. They fly 777s. You can get, you know, great upgrades and great frequent flyer mile usage. So I go the partner airline route as well. Another great little tip is, you know, oftentimes the awards, if you use your miles, are so high that if you ask for what is the least expensive economy ticket in which I can use miles to upgrade, you'd be amazed at the bargains you can get in terms of your upgrades of a, you know, decently priced ticket and then using much fewer miles to get a business class or first class seat. You know, I think what the hotel that always sticks out in my mind are the Oberoi's. When I was in India and the very first time I stepped into an Oberoi, I thought I had died and gone to heaven. Nothing like it in the world. Fantastic experiences. We stayed at several of the Oberoi's. You know, I like the Aman resorts. You know, obviously pretty spectacular too. And I like the peninsulas. You know, I've stayed at the peninsula in Shanghai, and I've stayed at the peninsula in Chicago. And you know, great hotels, great luxe experiences. But I think the Oberoi's are pretty amazing. Well, you know, the one at the Taj Mahal is, you know, hard to beat. So, I mean, there you are, and you open your door, your balcony door, and you know, there's the Taj out into the distance. So, but we stayed at the Taj at the Oberoi in Jaipur, and we stayed at the one in Agra, and I'm trying to remember the third one, but certainly the one that oversees the Taj is pretty spectacular. I think the one that I loved the best was in Bali, because Bali is such a magical island to begin with, and going to that resort, it captures all of the spirit of the Balinese life, and the way it's situated and where it's situated, you know, up in the hills and up in the rice paddies, was a great memory. So entering that was, you really felt like it was built as part of the local culture. So, you know, luxury, a lot of luxury is time, and having the time to do all the things you want to do. Some other, you know, icons of luxury, I think, today are things like not taking your phone with you. I went on a vacation, and decided not to turn my phone on, and it was amazing. You know, it's 2 days of massive withdrawal, but by the time you get to the third day, you realize how we are so connected all the time. And luxury is a mobile-free vacation, or just staying unplugged and unconnected. I think that's going to become more and more what people are thinking about. So those are some great examples. You know, I think obviously going to a destination where you can be pampered and have a great time is also, you know, the obvious in terms of luxury. I go to this great little wine lodge in Mendoza, Argentina, and it is a great little sanctuary to get away. It's nestled in a vineyard with the Andes Mountains off in the distance. And, you know, to me, that's a great little luxury to have that kind of experience. My next trip is in early March of this year. I'm going to Tanzania to run a marathon at Mount Kilimanjaro, at the base of Kilimanjaro. I've got a sister, one of my sisters and I are running a marathon on every continent. So we are, Africa will be our fifth. And then in August, we go to Mongolia, and we'll be running a marathon in Mongolia. And then in the spring of 2014, we will be going to Antarctica to run a marathon in Antarctica. So that won't be luxury. That will be adventure. Mongolia too, we'll be staying in yurts. So, you know, it's gonna be a little rustic, but yeah, the next trip is, those are sort of the next big trips. And then when we get all seven marathons done, we'll have completed that bucket list. So the book is called The Globetrotter Diaries, Tales, Tips, and Tactics for Seeing the Seven Continents. And it's available on Amazon and in bookstores near you. I'm Michael Clinton, and you're watching Destination Luxury.